the open door. Maybe it sounds better than that. I say, you've seen how I feel to God for no reason, right? How I flipped you off for no reason?
I'm not hearing the word distinctly.
No, no. I said, you know how I flipped you off for no reason? You know how I told you fuck you for no reason, right?
You talking about you didn't attack anybody for no reason? Is that what you're saying?
Okay, you know how I told you fuck you for no reason? How I flipped you off for no reason?
I'm sorry, I was able to pick up the word. I mean, I suppose I could come, you know, talk to you at some point, or do you have like another distinct question?
No, no, no. Okay, well, yeah. My question was.
Making me paranoid. I'm not gonna lie.
I'm not gonna lie to you. That's why I stay up so late. Because it's making me paranoid. I'm gonna use the right word. Scared. Only one of the days. It's messing with my mind, you know, I'm seeing things and hearing things that are not there. And it's all because of your staff members that have came into my area unannounced. And when I go out and see them, they startle me. And I do something, protect myself, whatever, and yet I get in trouble. But the thing is, that has affected my brain really, really bad. Because, dude, I'm freaking scared. You can even ask Jim the other day, I wasn't even talking to him. I was scared as hell. And thinking your staff members were going to come over here. But I didn't understand why. I mean, I know they're not going to kill me, at least I hope not. I know they're not going to beat me, at least I hope not. But for some reason,
nobody wants to hurt you. My dad is a nurse. We always want to provide a safe environment for everybody.
Yeah, no, I understand. But I'm saying what my state of mind is while being in here. You know, while being in here, I'm stripped of everything. But is Dr. Body gonna listen, or is it gonna be just like, cause if it's gonna be a waste of my time, and I got plenty of it, I don't need to go there just so to see some heads shaking up and down and give me a piece of paper. They can just slide it under my door. See, that's the thing. You guys want to medicate me with the problem is right here. Now, I'm not telling you this so you can get me out or open the doors or nothing like that. No. I'm just telling you to inform you. This place ain't where I'm in this small-ass area with the camera right there and you can see me. Hello. It messes with my mind. I mean, look at, I've been going to sleep late. With the door open, pacing back and forth, and yet, your guys is, instead of solving the problem, you guys are just a temporary fixing it with the pill. This is the thing, I didn't have these thoughts like this when I was out there, but now I do. And, I mean, I get over them, and to be honest, being in the going to the bathroom, is where I get over them. This room, for some reason, scares me. Oh, not scares me, but it's, I don't really, you know, it's not just this, it's just the room in general because the door can lock all the way. You know? And that's one of the things that frightened me, is that it could lock all the way, and at least I know the bathroom door can't. That one, you can't lock it all the way. And there, like I said, I feel safe after a while. But believe me, I go through my moments of torment. I mean, I know I'm not the most perfect and or nothing, but I don't deserve this. I mean, I was even requesting to go to county jail. I called the cops about my warrant so I could get turned in, and they refused. Now, you were telling me that I was telling people that I was going to kill them, right?
Okay, you're talking about the conversation we had about Corporal Fairfield, the one that you came back from Syria.
Yeah. So then, these people, you know, whatever their crime would be, actually, you know, they should be taken serious because, first of all, they're out of their mind, I'm sure. I'm not saying they are, I'm not sure. But, you know, to have committed the crime like Marshall when he ate his girlfriend's brains. Now, that's crazy. That even trips me out. I'm like, how in the hell are you going to kill your girlfriend and eat her brains? But anyhow, it's these people have done worse than I, and yet they have three, many of them have friends and staff members and doctors and even hit. You remember when, what's his name, used to be right here, the crazy dude? The white boy?
I didn't really get my brother.
No, I know. Justin. Jason. We're not going to talk about him, though.
I remember, you know, people that have been on that unit.
Okay, well, Jason knocked out the nurse, the female nurse. He threatened to kill a variety of people. So, why all these other people that have threatened staff, are they getting punished the same way as I am? Redirect me one time.
I
Okay, now I've been redirected more than once, and I don't think I've assaulted none of the registries or none of that. And I've been redirected more than once. Now, I get mad, and I tell them, don't fucking tell me what to do. Because, like I said, if the hospital follows its rules, why should I? Now, I mean, okay.
Prevent a lot of time from, you know, anyone getting hurt, and whether that's a problem that I would like, but
Okay, but how many times did you redirect them? Ain't you the boss? You're the boss.
Like I said, we'll finish that conversation.
That's all I gotta say.
Out because the whole thing with the back.
back room? That was uncalled for. But, I mean, at the end, I mean, damn, man, I mean, I guess. Yes, no, this was your decision, the lighting, because I would turn it off. Yeah, there was light shining in. It's all the shit the hospital has done to me. How do you expect me to follow its rules if it doesn't follow its own rules or policies? Like when I needed to send out legal mail, that one nurse, the fucking douchebag went and let me, the one that comes around 5 or 6 or something like that. But yeah, I wrote a grievance and they said that that never happened. So it's like, basically, like being in one thing, I'm going to be honest, being in here is making me paranoid. I'm not gonna lie to you. That's why I stay up so late, because it's making me paranoid. I'm gonna use the right word, scared. Only one of the days. It's messing with my mind, you know, I'm seeing things and hearing things that are not there. And it's all because of your staff members that have came into my area unannounced, and when I go out and see them, it startles me. And I do something, protect myself, whatever, and yet I get in trouble. But the thing is, that has affected my brain really, really bad. Because, dude, I'm freaking scared. You can even know Jim the other day, I was even talking to him. I was scared as hell. And thinking your staff members were going to come over here. But I didn't understand why. I mean, I know they're not going to kill me, at least I hope not. I know they're not going to beat me, at least I hope not. But for some reason,
nobody wants to hurt you. Everyone, you know, my narrative is that they're safe. We always want to provide a safe environment for everybody.
Yeah, no, I understand, but I'm saying, what my state of mind is while being in here. You know, while being in here, I'm stripped of everything.
I can't imagine how difficult it is being in there. I think those thoughts and feelings need to be conveyed, and I will document everything that, you know, we talked about today and everything I talk. You need to talk to your doctor, in this case, Dr. Body, so you can help address those issues.
But is Dr. Body going to listen, or is it going to be just like, because if it's going to be a waste of my time, and I got plenty of it, I don't need to go there just so to see some heads shaking up and down and give me a piece of paper. They can just slide under my door. No, see, that's the thing. You guys want to medicate me with the problem is right here. Now, I'm not telling you this so you can get me out or open the doors or nothing like that. No. I'm just telling you to inform you. This place ain't where I'm in this small-ass area with the camera right there and you can see me. Hello. It messes with my mind. I mean, look at, I've been going to sleep late with the door open, pacing back and forth, and yet, your guys is, instead of solving the problem, you guys are just a temporary fixing it with is where I get over them. This room, for some reason, scares me. Oh, not scares me, but it's just the room in general, because the door can lock all the way, you know? And that's one of the things that frightened me, is that it could lock all the way, and at least I know the bathroom door can't. That one, you can't lock it all the way. And there, like I said, after a while, I go in and I feel safe after a while. But believe me, I go through my moments of torment. I know I'm not the most perfect and for nothing, but I don't deserve this. I mean, I was even requesting to go to county jail. I called the cops about my warrant so I could get turned in, and they refused. Now, you were telling me that I was telling people that I was going to kill them, right?
Scares the hell out of me.
know, you got like 11, 12, 13, 14 big ass people that are gonna come in and obviously put hands on you. And you know what I've been through. And yet, what reaction do you expect from me?
James was a bully.